Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is the WAP, wireless application protocol. So this is one of the important concepts. So what is this application protocol, this wireless application protocol? So in this unit, I want to give a little introduction about this WAP. So the wireless protocol is a set of protocol, which allow data exchange for mobile cellular system, so this is the WAP. A wireless application protocol is a set of protocols which allows the data exchange. This is a main concept, data exchange. This protocol is using for the data exchange for mobile cellular system. For mobile cellular system, if you want to transfer the data from one device to another device, a set of protocols which allows the data exchange, that protocol is the wireless application protocol. Okay, so it is a device independent. The main important, it is device independent. So whatever the device that you are using, it doesn't bother about the device that you are using. Okay, so it's completely device independent. Whether you are using a mobile phone or you are using a laptop or you are using any tablet or whatever it may be, it's a device, completely device independent. And network independent also. It is a network independent. So what type of network you are using, it doesn't bother about. The main aim of here, the wireless application protocol, is data exchange for mobile computing. Data exchange for mobile computing, but so it is a device independent as well as a network independent. Okay, so I want to just give a brief, like the current constraints of wireless interface and the mobile devices so far you are using. Current constraints of let's take the wireless interface. So whatever the wireless interface you are taking and the mobile devices, so what are the current constraints of these devices, so which are not using the WAP? So here the current constraints for this is the wireless interface is having the less bandwidth and it's having the high latency and less stable connection. The device range of network is standard. These are the constraints for the wireless interface. Then what about the mobile devices constraints? It is here the mobile devices less CPU power and less memory and the storage. Restricted power consumption. And a small or variable size of displays. So these are the current constraints of the a device, whether it is any wireless interface or the mobile devices. So even though these having these type of constraints, the wireless interface is having these constraints and the mobile device are having these constraints, even though it's having drawbacks, the wireless application protocol is supporting these wireless interface as well as the mobile devices, because it is a device independent and the network independent. So it doesn't bother about what type of device you're using and what type of network you are using. The wireless application protocol is a set of protocol which allows the data exchange from mobile cellular system. Okay, now let me explain you why we use WAP. Wireless application protocol. So what's the need of using this WAP, wireless application protocol? Actually, the wireless network and the phones, so if you take the wireless network and mobile phones, if you take, so let me explain why we are using WAP here. If you take the wireless network and the phones, which have a specific needs, specific needs and requirements. So the wireless networks and the mobile phones have the specific needs and the requirements not addressed by existing internet technology. Actually, wireless networks and the phones is having the specific needs and the requirements, but which are not addressed by the existing internet technology. So if it is not addressed by the internet technology, some protocols will not support. But WAP is a device independent and the network independent, so it supports for transferring the data between the wireless net, between any systems in the case of wireless networks, or it may be a phone. And next, WAP enables any data transport. WAP enables any data transport. Means it can take like it can support the TCP/IP protocol for transferring the data, TCP/IP protocol, UDP or IP protocol, or it can access the SMN, or it can use the USSD also. Okay, and here the WAP architecture has several modular entities which together form a fully compliant internet entity. Okay, so here the WAP architecture, which is has a several module entities which together form a fully compliant internet entity. And WAP utilizes standard internet markup language. Okay, here the WAP utilizes standard internet markup language technology like XML. So because of using the XML, it has some standard internet markup language technique XML will be using. So finally, what you can say why we are using WAP? Finally, we can say the WAP architecture provides solution to network operators that are interoperability, scalable, reliable, efficient and secure. Okay, so the final I want to tell you is that WAP is provide solution to network operators. Like what type of solution it is providing to the network operators? Like interoperable, scalable, reliable, efficient and secure. So just remember these points. Thank you.